ever have a witness in here. They showed their commitments. They showed their contracts. But here's what I want you to understand today, that whenever you come to the point where you learn to find Jesus, then not only do you see who you are, you not only see what you're able to show, then now thirdly, now you can display your reason for coming this way. Can I tell somebody who they were, they showed what they had, but now they show why they came. Why did they came? Because they're coming today. First of all, they showed the universal impact of the coming of Jesus Christ. Watch this, his coming, beloved, was not just for a certain people, but you got to know his coming was for all people. Are y'all in here with me? His coming was not only, I believe, a universal impact, but I believe his coming suggested that his coming would give an indifference impact. In other words, there is no respect of person. Are y'all in here with me? In other words, the coming of Jesus Christ, beloved, he would not make the difference of who you are. He just really wanted you to know who you believed. Can I say something to you, beloved? If God can change the heart of Louis Farrakhan, don't you tell me God can't change the heart of me and you. I want to suggest to somebody, if you can testify that Jesus was the mighty Lamb of God that came through 42 generations born in Bethlehem, died on Calvary, but raised from the grave, can I tell you, he came to testify, all power would be in my hand. Do I have a witness in here? The text says, when they got there, what did they see? So they saw, yes, this young baby, this young child with his mother, Mary. I believe the text says, yes, they fell down. The text says, and they worship him. But this is what I like about the text. Here it is. They didn't just come, but when they came, they brought something. Are y'all in here with me? What did they bring? The text says, and when they opened up, verse 11, their treasures. The text says, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Are y'all in here with me? Here it is, being warned of God in a dream that he asked they should not return to Herod. Watch what they did. The text says they departed into their own country another way. Why is that significant? Because I believe the providential care of the Almighty God that said, yes, the time of Jesus' departure had not come. And I believe today, Herod would suggest that, yes, there could not be no other king like me. But I thank God this morning that he asked, whenever I come to the point where I am really in worship. Can I tell you what worship will do? Worship, it will, first of all, give me lead, guide, and direction. Whenever I come to the point where, yes, I am really in worship. Worship then will help me to focus on the true and tried Jesus Christ. That's why I tell you, beloved, whatever you have going on in your life, I stop by to tell you, whatever you have dealing with in your home, I stop by to tell you that, yes, whatever you have going on in your purpose, I stop by to tell you that, yes, you got to learn to worship Jesus Christ. Have I gotten to help him? For yes, if you learn to worship Jesus Christ, it would be in an effort to declare that he is the Son of God. Are y'all in here with me? If you learn to worship Jesus Christ, it would be a fulfillment of prophecy. I told you on last Sunday, the Old Testament said that there would be one to come. Have I gotten to help him here? And he shall be called Wonderful, he shall be called Counselor, he shall be called the Everlasting, Prince of Peace, and his name shall be called Jesus. Y'all need to hear with me. I gotta tell the Lord, thank you, sir, because the reason of my worship is because God thought enough of me. Have I got the help in here that he answered? He wouldn't insert himself in a 14-year-old girl. Can I hear Mary sing? How can I bring forth a child? Have I got the help in here? But aren't you glad that when God, he gives command, God will always handle your position. Y'all in here with me? How do you know? The Bible says that Mary brought forth a son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room in the inn. Excuse me, y'all, but I thank God that there was no room. Y'all in here with me? I gotta thank God that he ends. There wasn't no Marriott's. I gotta thank God there wasn't no Hilton's. Have I got to help him in? I gotta thank God there wasn't no Airbnb. Y'all in here with me? The only thing that they had for Mary was a little bitty boy on the outside of the stable. Have I got to help him? The Bible says she took him, she laid him in a manger. Have I got to help you? The king got word. He sent him in. He sent a groom and find them baby. Have I got to help you? The thing I like about them going is they went for one thing, but here it is again. God had another in his mind. Have I got to help you? The Bible says that when they got to the child, they found him in the hall with mama. Have I got to help you? Can you see Jesus in the arms of his mother? But I thank God the wise men didn't do like some of y'all. When you see the newborn baby, you ask, can I hold him? Have I got to help him here? The wise men didn't do like some of y'all. Then when you see a brand new baby, you ask, can I feed him? Have I got to help him here? But when I really need you to change the baby's diaper, what you want to do is run away. But thank God for these wise men. When they found Jesus in the arms of his mother, they bowed down and worshiped him. Anybody in the Friendship Church got a made up mind that you come to worship him? Is there anybody in the Friendship Church got a made up mind to come to lift up his name? Have I got to help him here? Can I tell somebody, if you don't worship him, that's all right. Can I tell you what he got now? He got some wrongs that'll cry out in your place. But is there anybody glad? I know the Lord, and he knows me, and I ain't gonna let no rock cry out in my presence. Have I got to help you? He's been good, and the Lord's been kind. He brought me from a mighty long way. Anybody in him got a praise on your heart? Anybody in him got a worship in your spirit? Can I get a one witness in? The reason why I worship him is because his birth is not like any birth before. I worship him because your birth and my birth, it took our mamas and daddies getting together. Are y'all in here with me? But I'm so very glad that I heard Jesus say, Father, if you prepare me a body, I'll go down with the man of his sin. Can I tell you what he did? He came down through 42 generations. I'm gone now. He came down from heaven to earth. Can I tell you what he did? He inserted himself in Mary. For 9 months, he rode the train of nature. Have I got to help you? And I'm so glad that what Jesus did, he stayed there until the time of delivery. Can I tell you I'm glad? If he had not been born, my preaching would be in vain. If he had not been born, your worship would be in vain. But every day, I can't have a birth unless I have a death. And I'll tell you the reason why. He was born to die on a cross. Can I get one witness? He died from the sixth to the ninth hour. Are y'all in here with me? They hung him high and stretched him wide. He died till the heaven was satisfied. Can I tell you what I'm mad about? As he hung up there, the earth, it reeled and rocked on his axis. As he hung up there, the stars that the wise men saw began to drop out of their socket. He hung up there. The worm gave up the dead man, and they walked around the streets of Jerusalem. I'm so mad that the soldiers that began to cast lots for his garment, when he hung up there, said, "Surely this must be the Son of God." Can I see y'all later? Can I tell you goodbye? I'll see you next week for sermon topic number 3. But before I go, I got to tell someone, he died, but that ain't the end of my story. He hung his head in the locks of his shoulder. "Father, into thy hand I commend my spirit." They took him off that cross. They laid him in a rich man's grave. Can I shout with you today? He stayed there hard night Friday. He stayed there hard day Saturday. But can I get up now and say early Sunday morning, Sunday morning, anybody in here, I'm glad he got up. Anybody in here, I'm glad he got all power. He got him with all power in his hand. And I ask you a question, ain't he worthy? Y'all ain't saying nothing. And I ask you one more time, ain't he worthy? Yeah, y'all caught on. I need everybody to get excited about Christ. And I ask you one last time, he worthy? Shout back with me, Jesus, do you know who he is? My way out of no way, Jesus, do you know who he is? My storm, my shelter from the storm and blast, do you know who he is? Food when I'm hungry, clothes when I'm naked, water when I'm thirsty, have I got any help in here? My wheel in the middle of the wheel, can I ask you a question? Won't he do it? Help in here. Have you tried him? Won't he make a way for you? Say yeah. Say yeah. Oh yeah. He loves him. He loves him. He loves him. Hey. He loves him. Hey. To be praised. I don't know who you are, I don't know where you're sitting, don't know where you're standing. But the reality of my conviction is, if I'm going to take off the Bethlehem last Sunday, this Sunday I ought to have a worship in my spirit. Do I have a witness in here? And if you take off the Bethlehem and don't worship God for who he is in the flesh and form of his son Jesus Christ, can I tell you, your coming is in vain. And those of us that come Sunday after Sunday, sit in the sanctuary silently like statues and won't worship a Savior. But can I tell you, you better worship him, because he is coming back. Yeah, y'all do know he's coming back, don't you? When he comes, he ain't coming for everybody. But when he comes, he's coming for them and they and us and you who have If you want to give God a real big praise in this place, head into Bethlehem. Worship in Bethlehem.